SQL Database Projects in Azure Data Studio is bringing new functionality from SSDT to other platforms like Azure Data Studio, which runs across Linux, Windows, and Mac. Learn more in this episode of Data Exposed. Hi, I'm Anna Hoffman, and welcome to this episode of Data Exposed. Today, I'm joined by Drew Squires-Kabbala, a program manager on the Azure Data team. Thanks for joining us today, Drew.
Thanks for having me.
And before we get started, I thought it'd be good for you to tell us a little bit about what you do.
I recently joined Microsoft as a program manager, and I focus on experiences for database administrators and database developers. This matches right with my previous experience where I spent a decade as a database administrator and developer prior to joining Microsoft.
Awesome. Cool. And, you know, speaking of things DBAs do, today I think you're going to talk about something that's new to Azure Data Studio, but not new to, you know, the database administrator's toolbox or things that they usually do. Can you tell us a little, you know, preview teaser about what that is?
Yeah, so SQL database projects are an adaptation of the database developer experience in SQL Server data tools. So from Visual Studio, we have this rich experience for database developers to build and deploy database projects, and now we're bringing this experience to a cross-platform world with SQL database projects.
Awesome. Cool. I'm excited to learn more. I don't know anything about this. So I saw that you prepared some very interesting use of a notebook. So I thought maybe we could show that and you could tell us more about SQL Database Project.
Yeah, sounds great. So in Azure Data Studio, as you mentioned, we have these notebook concepts. And in notebooks, you can embed Markdown. In this case, I had just a few visuals that I wanted to bring today. And I dropped them into Markdown cells where we're able to render those images and then very quickly explain to our viewers a little bit about the different cross-platform tools that are available for database developers. So in this bigger picture for SQL database projects, we're looking to bring that database developer experience to Azure Data Studio because development as a whole is becoming more enriched with cross-platform development pathways. Most people are familiar with Visual Studio Code. It's this great rich editor where you're able to build applications, and through the MS SQL extension, you're able to query databases. Less people are familiar with this great tool for automation, which is SQL package.exe. You're able to take these DACPAC database files and automate extract and publish operations through this command line tool. And just like Visual Studio Code, SQL package.exe is available for not only Windows, but also Linux and Mac OS. Last but not least is Azure Data Studio, and that's where we're enjoying this rich notebook experience. And that's where you're able to deploy, query, and administer databases. And through all of those great first and third party extensions, we're able to add functionality like SQL database projects. What I want to show everyone today with SQL database projects is how we're able to take an existing database, could be on a production server, bring that into a project, and then as a database developer, make some changes to that database project, change the database schema. Finally, we're able to build the project and validate our changes, and finally publish it to a test server. Over on the left, we have our connections pane. And from our production server, we can see that we have AdventureWorks deployed. I'm going to import a project from the database, selecting the production server, and then our AdventureWorks database. We'll organize the files by object type. And in just a few seconds, it's going to extract the database schema into this collection of files over here on the left. So for example, we can see the database definition for the customer table. As a database developer, I've been instructed to add some functionality for rewards points. So for my customer, I'm going to add a column for rewards points. That is an int. And we're going to allow this column to be null. And I'm saving the change to the table definition here in the project. I have not altered our production database. This is all done in this SQL database project. In validating these changes, I can go ahead and click on that project and build. And that build task will kick off here in the output.
So while that's building, you know, this is just doing something that I used to do in SSDT. Now, is this something that I can do in SSMS, or is this something that, you know, today I can only do in Azure Data Studio with the extension or SSDT?
This is something that you can only do in SSDT on Windows, or now in Azure Data Studio on Windows, Linux, and Mac OS.
Okay, cool. Awesome. So now I have this new functionality that I didn't have before if I was running on Linux or Mac.
The collaboration potential for teams that are cross-platform is really amplified here through Azure Data Studio. Now that we've built our project, we're going to go ahead and publish it to a test server. And we're going to call it our AdventureWorks database and publish. And while that publishes, we're going to hop over to our test server. It's deploying the DAC pack. There's no database yet. The test server is empty while it publishes. And once it finishes publishing, we'll be able to see that empty but full schema database there. And we can even check out that table change that we made to the customer table. Now our application developers are able to work with the modified schema with rewards points. So that was able to take us through a really quick development pipeline, but within Azure Data Studio. So for those cross-platform teams, we're bringing the power of SSDT into a new enriched environment. So if I haven't convinced you yet that this is bringing SQL projects into a cross-platform environment, I'm sure you've gotten that point. But the other really important thing is that this is this declarative database development cycle that you get from SQL Server data tools. So you're able to develop, build, and publish instead of directly modifying a production database. So it kind of lowers that risk of breaking changes. This preview experience of SQL database projects is available in Azure Data Studio. You can get it from the extension store. So when you go into that extension marketplace, if you search for SQL database projects, you can install this extension and get started with your own database projects today.
Thanks, Drew. That was really cool. And I liked how easy it is to use and kind of how intuitive it is that you would build your project, then you'd publish it, and you can even publish it to a test server. One question I had is, you know, you noted that these were both, you know, SQL servers or Azure SQL databases or whatnot. Is this something that works across on-premises and Azure?
Yes. All of the Azure SQL and SQL Server products that are supported by SQL Server data tools come right over into this experience. So you're talking about Azure SQL Database, you're talking about Azure SQL MI or Managed Instances. All of those experiences come with.
Awesome. Cool. Now, if you had one tip to give our users if they're getting started with this, you know, or one piece of advice on building this, given your experience building this feature out, what would it be?
I would say start playing with it as soon as you can, because changing your development cycle to something that can have source control more easily, like this declarative development cycle, really adds a level of safety to your development and avoids breaking changes that impact your production environments.
Awesome. Cool. I like that tip. Just start using it as soon as you can. Simple, but, you know, straight to the point. So thanks, Drew, for being on the show with us. We'll put some links to learn more in the description of this video. For our viewers, if you like this video, please like this video and let us know what you're doing with this extension in Azure Data Studio. We hope to see you next time on Data Exposed.